saved at one time. And it's fine to be a choice. I don't agree with that. It was never a choice because when the powers that be have the military, the police, and the intelligence on their side, there is no equal. There's no equal fight right there. And even when though everyone has put down the guns, has put down the chains around my neck, my ankles, it don't have a way to play because they cannot. Because they can deny you equal opportunity. Equal opportunity is a form of slavery. So you see, I'm looking at it in this way. I'm not looking at it as, you see where I'm going with this?
I do see it. Thank you for your call. Yeah, right. Exactly. See you going. Let's go to Ohio to Victor. Victor, you keep me going with Al Sharpton.
Well, how you doing?
I'm doing well. How are you?
Hey, I'm doing good. Can you hear me real well? Because I got some wind in my back here.
Yeah, I hear you well now. Yep.
Okay. A part of what Kanye West said that I wanted to allude to, he was talking about 400 years. I think when he went off into talking about mental slavery, and I think that what I believe he was talking about in terms of mental slavery, is the mindset of other people. We have been trapped in this mindset that every election we got to vote for the Democrats. For the last 60 years, black folks have, the vast majority of black folks in this country have lived in and around the inner cities in this country. And yet these places are continuously being ran into the ground. Now black folks are being gentrified. In Los Angeles, illegal immigrants are running black folks out of their out of the neighborhoods that they've been living in for a long time. And I think Kanye was kind of alluding to that more.
Well, let me ask you a question. He said for the last 60 years we've been voting Democrat. What were we voting before that?
Well, pretty much the black population was more towards the Republican. I think it's
right. Why did we go from the Republican to the Democrat?
Why did we go? Because the Dixie crap. Now listen, Malcolm X. I just heard him.
No. Don't start quoting Malcolm X.
You made a point,
and I'm asking you on your point. You said that we voted Democrat in the last 60 years. I said, where were we voting before that? You said large part of Republican. Why did we from Republican to Democrat?
Because you had the white racist Democrats who went into the Republican Party. And therefore
the Republican Party and took their white racist Democrats and therefore left the party. Which showed we were not non-thinking. That shows thinking. The point you made is undermines what Kanye and you are saying. If we weren't thinking, we'd have stayed Republicans. When you said the Dixiecrats went into the Republicans, we said, fine, we'll go where our interests lie. And if the Republicans went and dealt with our interests now, we go back Republican.
Okay, you're making a good point there, but the problem is the Democrats haven't dealt with our interests. Look at the House.
Absolutely. They have not dealt with our interests to the degree they should, but they have certainly dealt with our interests more than the Republicans.
Well, that's simply because the black community won't give the Republican Party half a chance.
Oh, no, they're women, bro. They're women, women, women. You don't go to a store and give your money and then decide what you want to buy. You pay for what you get. What? Oh, so you say we ought to vote for them and then they may do something?
No.
Now you're not thinking at all.
No. Yes, I am. Because my point to you is this, brother. Black folks have been living in these hell holes in these inner cities for a long time, and they've been ran by Democrats. And now,
black folk have been living in these hell holes for years. Many of the cities run by Democrats. And the federal government in the last 60 years, you knew 60, has been run more by Republicans than Democrats, who sends the monies down to the cities and who controls the Justice Department. If you go back 60 years, from Nixon till now, you've had more Republicans controlling the years in the White House and therefore the Justice Department, because that's who appoints the Attorney General, that's who appoints the judges, they're Democrats. Problem y'all got with me when y'all call yourself free thinking is that you gotta have facts. Because I'm a real free thinking black man. I do my research for out of my mouth. Thank you for your call. Let's go to Victoria in the Bronx, New York.
Now, how you doing?
I'm doing well. How you doing?
How you doing, Dr. Charles Donaldson? I am fine. You know, as Kanye West goes, I don't know if I should call him a loser or what. But I remember when I was a kid, my mother always kept the genealogy of our family in the Bible. In fact, there was a section in the Bible where we could put down our genealogy. And one of the ways we could start combating what Kanye is saying and how we can let our young people know is to talk to our young people about our family history. That's what my parents used to do. A lot of times, they would tell us about when they were growing up. I didn't even know that they were talking about history and genealogy at the same time. And I mean, unfortunately, there are a lot of blacks like Kanye that have forgotten where they come from. They decide to assimilate. And as far as the brother, the caller before, you are absolutely right. Then in the last 6 years, we've had more Republicans because I used to live in California as a 16 years straight. We had George Duke Magian and Pete Wilson. For 16 years straight, we were under Republican rule, and we had a black Republican that helped get rid of affirmative action in the state of California. So it's not about the cities, it's not about blaming Obama. It's the fact that when you have more of the Republicans that are destroying this country and voting against our best interests, that's what's happening. So it's not that we decide to stay slaves, and our ancestors decide to stay slaves. It's because that's the way they voted, because they didn't control.
And see, all I'm saying, and thank you for your call, bro, Victoria, is that I don't think that the Democrats are perfect. I think, I mean, that's one of the reasons I ran for president, challenging the Democrats. But don't act like we aren't thinking to go with the best choice. If you only have two choices, it's going to win. And that's why I made him go back and have to admit himself that the fact of the matter is that we used to vote all Republican. They turned on our interests, so we left. Now, it doesn't mean Democrats are by any stretch as a panacea, but it does mean that we have enough thinking and we have enough choice, Kanye, that we go with what is the best choice, even if it's not the perfect choice. Javon in Atlanta, WAOK 1380, you're keeping it real with Al Sharpton.
Hey, long time listener, first time caller. I have a couple questions for you. My question is for you is that if Kanye West stirring the pot so black people can come together as well as Donald Trump is? That's my question, because if you have
Kanye, what he's doing. I really don't. I mean, I've known Kanye casually. I don't know him well. And I don't know if he's stirring the pot for us to come together. I've never seen anybody do it this way. If that's what he's doing, this is really innovative.
Yeah, because he always with some controversies. And I think Donald Trump, you know, he's just being who he is. And black people, I think he's making us come together with all these videos of, police brutality and all that.
No, I think you're right about that. I think Trump is definitely set an ugly climate that is forcing a lot of us to say, you know what, we better start forgetting some of these boundaries we put around ourselves. Well, that's the reason I have to go. Let me thank Charles Ellison. Let me thank all of you that called in, listening, you that called in and couldn't get through. But hung in there anyhow. Remember, whatever you do, wherever you go, however you feel, tell somebody, tell anybody, tell everybody. Reverend Al, tell you personally. Keep it real.
Keep it real. Keep it real.
Talk to your mom.
Breaking news. The issues, the stories affecting you. Now, here's the news from News1.com.
I'm Ebony McMorris. A new report claims the special counsel in the Russia investigation raised the possibility of issuing a subpoena for President Trump if he doesn't volunteer to talk to investigators.
The Washington Post says special counsel Robert Mueller issued the warning during a meeting with Trump's lawyers back in March. During the meeting, Trump's legal team insisted that the president wasn't obligated to sit down with investigators. The Post also reports that investigators gave Trump's team an outline of 16 subjects they want to discuss with the president. Brian Shook, NBC News Radio.
White House lawyer Ty Cobb is retiring. He was one of the lawyers hired to represent Trump in the Russia investigation and will reportedly be placed by attorney Emmett Flood. Now, Flood represented President Bill Clinton during his impeachment drama in the 1990s. Cobb told ABC News that a presidential interview with special counsel Mueller has not been ruled out. A high school football coach in South Jersey is blaming racism for his firing.
Nick Strom, who's white, claims he was fired Monday night as a history teacher and head football coach at Camden Catholic for not having enough white players on his roster. Strom claims he was ordered by the school's president, Mary Whitkey, to give white players more playing time in order to connect with the school's alums. Whitkey is denying it, and the Diocese of Camden says it's investigating. Sarah Lee Kessler, NBC News Radio, New Jersey.
A cracked window led to an emergency landing of Southwest Airlines flight headed to Newark.
Images began to emerge on social media.